that it was time, this was our moment. My kids had affirmation since last night. We claimed this game. And so we knew from our shoot around this morning into coming into this arena that this was our game. And so we knew we were going to be battle tested, and we would stand it, and we ended out with the win.
Coach, game plan wise, when you're looking across at John Curse and they have all the guards, a lot of people would think you can't press them. You guys came out and pressed them, forced a lot of turnovers, switched it up from different types of presses. Was that kind of game plan coming in, or y'all just kind of fell into that?
Well, we've been pretty much been being able to do that all season. We've been very versatile with our athletes. We knew that we wanted to take them out of their game. We knew that we were capable of being able to switch up different defenses, throw them off. And so that was pretty much the plan coming into today.
It's kind of a matchup that we kind of expected coming down. Again, game plan wise, was there anything that they did surprised you?
No, not too much. We knew that they're able to shoot the three. We know they like to drive. And so we just knew that we needed to keep the pressure on them, and we needed to do a better job in blocking out. I said that's one thing we could have done better. Mm-hmm. But, you know, even with that, we knew that we had to control the tempo of the game.
Coach, and having that mentality and being able to force those turnovers, do you feel like that was kind of the deciding factor that you guys were able to get on, getting those turnovers early and then being able to score buckets too?
Yes, I do. And I think it also rattled them and took them out of their game. Mm-hmm. I don't know, probably since their Ponchatoula game for them was the last game where they really were tested. And so we knew coming in that what we need, that was our game plan. That's what we needed to do.
Coach, setting the defensive tempo, you held Curtis guards for 21 minutes without a basket. What differently that you saw on this game than all the previous games?
I did not.
Say that again. Sorry. I'm just listening to you. Okay, say that again.
21 minutes, you held them scoreless without a basket. What did you see differently on video versus games that led to your defense playing that well?
Well, we knew coming into this game that, number one, that she's been the person that controlled the tempo with the offense. And so we knew if we take her out of the game and make it difficult for her, that they would possibly struggle, and we were right.
I mean, it means everything. I mean, this was our goal going into the season. This has been my goal ever since I made it to high school. So being able to play a big role in my team winning means everything to me.
Talk about how you responded, your team responded once they came at you and tied you three times in the fourth quarter.
I'm sorry,
talk about how your team responded when they tied you three times.
We've honestly been in that situation many times. We've been up, we lost a lead, and same thing happened. But the difference between this time and that time is we let them come back. This time we held our composure, we stayed calm, and we played our game. We went back to how we started off the game, our defense, and we took our time on offense.
Coach, can you talk about the addition of Blackwell? How did that conversation go? How did you convince her to meet her in the hallway one day and say, look, how did that go down?
I believe my assistant was instrumental in that. And so when we were at the Sugar Bowl Classic, we had already been conversating about it. And so I think she ended up going to another game, and I think that was just the fuel that she needed. And we talked on the phone. I'm like, look, because she plays club volleyball, and so it's tough to be able to do both. And we always been open to balance it out for her. And like I told her, coming into it, look, we'll make it work. And that's exactly what we did. So we sat down and we talked about it, and when she came back, I think it was for the STM game. That was just the gas that we needed to push us all the way through.
Delilah, you came back for this moment. Just talk about what this means for you.
It definitely means everything. Like, this was always me and Chris's dream, being freshman playing on varsity. And just to be here in this moment with my team, my coaches, and everybody that supports us is just amazing.
Message at halftime was to pretty much to settle down. We control the tempo of the game. We know that we're going to have to make defensive stops along the way, and just to control the tempo.
And to you, Johnson, you played big this game. mindset coming into this game knowing that you had to help Blackwell and North Seaside?
I knew that I had to step up and be able to handle the ball in order for my team to be successful in offense. And
Johnson, oh, go ahead.
Oh, you good,
Like, it's very uncommon that you have the opportunity to have someone like Narcisse mentor you along the way. I asked her about you last time, and I wanted to ask you about her. How has it been, you know, to look up to that person that's, you know, walking the line and being that leader and a mentor? She's, you know, accomplishing the dream that you want to accomplish in 2 years from now. How's that been?
It's been great because it's like she gives me kind of a role model to look up to and to kind of like, you know, try to mold my game after in my my high school career.
For any one of you players, how nerve-wracking did it become in these final minutes? I mean, that's something you wanted and longed for so long, and it looked like it was going great, and then all of a sudden it gets kind of hairy there. What's going through your mind in those closing minutes?
Well, for me, I find myself as the emotional leader of the team, so I knew that I had to step up and be that person that they can look to and know that it's all right. Like, we gave them a few buckets, but we know who we are as a team, and we just have to trust that our coaches and everybody else has our back, and we can finish the game.
Is that why you flexed on me after you get the alternate
alphabet? I mean, it might do a little something, you know?
Coach, we talked about this when it came out that you were going select. We talked about this and knew that you were going to be gotta be there in the end. We talked about that. Mm-hmm. And you're here.
Yes, sir.
You got it.
Yes, sir.
How special is it?
Oh my God, it is so special. It's amazing. When they came in, we knew that the group that we had was special. And every year we've gotten better and better. And so for the last couple of years, we've placed ourselves as one of the top teams in the state. So we just knew that we just carried that expectation for ourselves. And then coming into, like, today, we just needed something to be that driving force. So with that crystal ball prediction, you know, it said that we were not going to come on top. And so that's the gas they needed. That's the gas they needed. And so thank you so much, because we was looking for something.
Yes.
We needed something. And when we saw that, we were locked in. We were locked in since we woke up this morning. We're ready for this moment.
For the record, I picked y'all.
Smart guy. So,
he already picked
smart guy. We're off to South Alabama. Going to be your roommates, I think.
Yes.
How special is that to get to walk out of here? State champs, go party it up, and
smart.
Then on to your next journey.
Honestly, it's surreal. It never even hit me yet. I'm still not realizing we actually just won it. But I'm glad we did. Like I said, this was our goal since we got here. So I'm glad that this my final game was able to do it.
Yeah, me and Chris, we've been best friends for a long time. So she's definitely a person that I'm happy that I got to, like, celebrate this with, because she's, like, she's amazing. Like, she's, like, I don't even know how to explain it. Like, she's just so much. Like, she's a great leader, great role model, and she's a bucket. She has a dog. She has the dog in her. So it's, like, it's just great, honestly.
Before we get out of here, you've done a great job surrounding yourself with great coaches. I know a lot of people have a lot to do with this. Can you talk about your coaching staff over the last year and how much of an impact they've made?
Oh, my God. My coaches are amazing. I could not do this without them. We balance each other. We're always on the wavelength. It's crazy because we already know what each other is thinking or saying before it even happens. And so we know coming into this, everybody has a role to play. From our coaches, even with the players, and we've set that as the standard. And so I appreciate them, I love them, and they mean everything to me. We could not do this. I could not do this without them.
Coach, you lose those two to your right. You bring the one to your left back, bring Grace Paul back. Where does Lafayette Lady Lions basketball go from here?
I'll tell you what, we're going to be back. We've been blessed early on in the year. We had two freshmen that came in. And, I mean, with the strength of our schedule, it was tough for them. And so they had to step up, and they had to play. Sometimes we played with 5 and 6 people. And so I think that made the difference down the stretch of the season in terms of experience and being out there. And so we have now players that have been here before. And so they got a taste of what this is like, and they wanted to. So we will be back.
Thank you, Coach.